Hello students, good afternoon everybody. In the previous value education session, we have seen which are good habits and which are bad habits. I have given one exercise to you to observe good habits and bad habits in you. And I am sure that you have done it. First of all, for good habits in you, clap for yourself. Very good children. And if you have any bad habit, I am sure that you will break it immediately and turn it into good one. And one more thing, students. Remember the stories related to the topics. You may tell the stories to your parents. Children, if you read something, you know it. If you visualize or write it, you will remember it. And if you discuss or tell it to somebody, that thing will get fixed in your mind forever. So, if you tell these stories to your parents or friends, the value will get fixed in your mind forever. Today, in this session, we will learn cleanliness and tidiness in detail, which will definitely help you to become healthy. Cleanliness and tidiness are two different things. Cleanliness is about cleaning our body, home, classroom, surroundings, etc. Whereas tidiness is about organizing your belongings, your books, notebooks, school bag, clothes, etc. Cleanliness manje swachhata, va tidiness manje taptip. So cleanliness and tidiness are two different concepts. First, we will talk about cleanliness. What is cleanliness? Why to remain clean? How to do cleaning? Or which are the various ways of cleaning? First, we will see the definition of cleanliness. Cleanliness is a state of remaining free from bacteria, germs, viruses, dust, and waste. Now, germs, bacteria, and viruses are present on human body and on different objects also. Cleanliness is a habit of maintaining our body, home, surroundings, and our country neat and clean. A person who maintains cleanliness keeps illness away. Yes, that's true. If you remain clean, if you stay in clean surroundings, you will be disease-free. You can keep illness away. Students, there is one saying, cleanliness is next to godliness. What is the meaning of this saying? We will see. Cleanliness means being physically clean and tidy. Godliness means being morally good. The words next to can be taken to mean second best after. First important thing is your behavior should be good. And then second thing is you should keep yourself clean. Now we will see cleanliness of body, mind, heart, speech and environment. Cleanliness of body means you have to keep yourself neat and clean. Every day, brush your teeth, take a bath, comb your hair, wear clean clothes. That comes in cleanliness of body. Cleanliness of mind means you have to think good about others. Means तुम्हारे विचार अच्छे होने चाहिए. Cleanliness of heart means we should love nature, animals, birds. Cleanliness of speech means you have to speak good words. Never use bad words. You should not be arrogant or talk harshly. Cleanliness of environment means you have to keep your surroundings clean. Take care of trees, plants, nature. Now, importance of cleanliness. Cleanliness prevents diseases away. You and your home, school, surroundings look better. You will feel fresh, energetic. You will look smart. Cleanliness, the first law of health, means if you are clean, your health will be always good. First, we will see personal cleanliness. Brush your teeth first thing when you get up in the morning and before going to bed at night, so that your teeth will not decay and remain healthy. Your teeth will spark, shine and look nice. You can enjoy your food. Take regular bath. Use soap, shampoo for washing your body and hair. Cut your nails regularly so that dust will not get collected under it. Children, when you play on the ground or play with some objects like ball, bat, your hands, feet and face gets dirty. There are various germs, viruses and bacteria on your body. These germs and viruses are invisible, means you cannot see them with your naked eyes. These germs and viruses are harmful and cause diseases or illness. Look, children, you can see how your hands become dirty. See. So you have to clean your hands, feet and face with soap. How to wash your hands? Now I will tell you in detail. For washing your hands, you have to use soap and warm water. If warm water is not available, ordinary water you can use. Scrub your hands very well. Wash between fingers, wrists, under fingernails, back of hands. At least 20 seconds you have to wash your hands with soap and water. Then your hands will become clean. Cleanliness of uniform. Students, always wear neat, clean and ironed uniform. Wash your socks daily. Polish your shoes every day. Always keep your hair short so that you can comb it easily. Now you will feel fresh, pleasant, and energetic. You will look smart, and everyone wants to make friendship with you. Now we will see cleanliness in home or housekeeping. Let's see how can we keep our house clean. We can keep our house clean by cleaning of furniture, cleaning of utensils, cleaning of floor walls, cleaning of carpets, curtains. Cleaning of doors, windows, cleaning of equipments like refrigerator, television, computer, washing machine. Children, you can help your parents to keep your house clean. How can you help? You can help by sweeping the floor, by dusting furniture, not writing on the walls, by keeping waste papers or wrappers in the dustbin. Your small deeds will help them a lot. तो बच्चों, हमेशा अपना घर साफ रखो. Now we will see cleanliness in classroom. Children, look at this classroom. It's very dirty, messy. You can see papers, pencil shavings, wrappers on the floor. Would you like to study in such classrooms? I know your answer. Your answer is no, never. So, how can we keep our classroom clean? We can keep our classrooms clean by do not throw pencil shavings on the floor. Do not make the classrooms or corridors dirty. Arrange all tables, chairs and benches neatly in rows. Do not write on walls, tables, benches. Do not play with paper balls, chalks, or any sharp objects. Do not drop or split food on benches or floor during lunch break. One more thing, students. When you are in school, you handle various objects such as books, notebooks, bag, pencil, erasers, pens, benches. That time there is a chance of transmission of germs, bacteria and viruses. So, before opening your lunch box and taking food, you must wash your hands properly. Also, you should avoid touching your face with dirty hands. Then, after craft or activity period, keep waste paper or waste material in dustbin. So, in this way, you should keep your class clean and your class will not become dirty. Now, student, listen one story. Atharva is a class monitor of standard 5th. Their teacher is very particular that everyone should attend the prayer in assembly. Those who will not attend will receive punishment. That day, Atharva finds that Sara has not attended the prayer. He asked Sara, "Sara, why did you skip the prayer? You know, our teacher is very strict about it." Before Sara could answer, the teacher enters the class. She asked monitor Atharva, "Did everyone attend the prayer today?" "Ma'am, except Sara, all came for the prayer." "What, Sara? Is it true what Atharva says?" "Did you stay away from the prayer?" asked teacher. The whole class is eagerly waiting to see Sara being punished. Except few are very jealous of Sara, who studies well, behaves well, speaks well. Her handwriting is neat. She keeps her books neat. "Sara, you know, whoever misses the prayer will be punished. Before giving you the punishment, I would like to know why you stayed away," asked teacher. Sara said, "Ma'am, I came to the class in time only, but the others have already gone for the prayer. So I kept my book inside the classroom and was about to go. But I noticed that the classroom was full of dust, papers, rubbish, and whatnot. The whole place was dirty and unhygienic. You have told us importance of cleanliness. The boy who is in charge of cleaning did not do his duty. So I cleaned the room and did not attend the prayer. Since you have taught us dignity of labor, I cleaned the class. If I have done something wrong, please pardon me, ma'am. I am ready to accept any punishment by you." Teacher said, "Sara, you have done a wonderful job. If everyone thinks and acts like you, our school will become famous. I am very proud to have you as my student. There is no punishment for you. Sara, from today, you will be the in charge of cleanliness. I will provide you the badge." And Sara becomes cleanliness in charge of standard 5th. So students, it is every student's duty and responsibility to keep the classroom and school premises clean. So students, keep your class always clean. Now we will see cleanliness of surroundings. Why or how our surroundings becomes dirty? Our surroundings become dirty by spillage of garbage, waste material like stale food, leftover, spitting on road, defecating and urinating on open spaces. Writing or drawing on walls. So how can we keep our surroundings clean? Our house and its surroundings must be kept clean always. We should keep our house and its surroundings always clean. We should not litter garbage around the house. The garbage must be collected in the covered dustbin and thrown at a proper dumping place. This waste material is collected by the municipal trucks and usually dumped in open ground outside the city. Cleanliness is very important for us. It is our duty to keep our surroundings clean. If we clean our surroundings, we can stand as an example to others. Others also can follow us. So students, today we have seen how can we keep ourselves, our home, our classroom, our surroundings, everything clean. Now we will see exercise. Look at the following pictures and write a story in your own words. See the picture carefully and you prepare your own story and write it in your notebook. Next question is, write down few names of cleaning tools or equipments. Next question, write down few names of cleaning materials or cleaning agents. One more question, write a short note describing how you help your parents to keep your home clean. Write down at least 5 to 6 sentences. Now students, listen one song. I enjoy it listening. I hope you will also like and enjoy it. children, if you take care of cleanliness of yourself, your house, your school, and your surroundings, then your country will become clean. Thus, you can be a part of Swachhata Abhiyan, Cleanliness Drive. Bacho, next time we will discuss about tidiness in detail. Stay clean, stay healthy.